In the upcoming videos, we'll be covering each one-line component and their configuration in detail. However, all of the components will be connected with buses. So before we go on, let's look at how this is done. There are two methods of creating buses, the electrical nodes in our network. The simplest method is the AutoConnect feature, which you see highlighted by default at the top of Graphics Builder. Let me demonstrate how this works. To begin, I'll drag out a utility component and a vertical bus bar. If I look at the busbar component, it has a globally unique name that is automatically populated. The utility component also has a property called busName that is currently blank. Let me zoom in a bit to see this next step more easily. If I drag the bus bar close to the utility, you can see a small green circle at the connection point. This indicates that AutoConnect will automatically copy the bus name from one component to the other. When I release the mouse, I can see that the bus name property has been populated with the name of the bus. That's all I needed to connect the two components in the one-line engine. I can use the same process to connect a horizontal bus bar to this bus, add breakers to the gear, or add meters to monitor the buses. However, there are situations the AutoConnect will not function. Maybe you need to connect from one page to another, or you're jumping bus from one section of a page to another. In these situations, you can simply fill in the bus names manually. Let me delete my components and recreate them. In this case, I'm going to change my bus bar name manually as well. While I could leave the default name, I'd rather set it to something more memorable, since I'm going to have to fill it out. I'll call this Utility 1 Bus. It doesn't matter what the name is, so long as it's unique in the project. I'll then set the bus name in the utility component. Our end result is the same in that the bus name is set in both locations, but now I don't have to physically connect the components together. This is how we set our bus node names, and this method applies to each one-line component that we're about to cover. I'll go ahead and delete this, and in the next video, I'll start populating my real source components. Until then, thank you.